This really is, although we're doing some parliamentary procedures here, at base we are dealing with a very critical issue, one that has much to do with ethics and morals and religious views, which are going to impact the University of Minnesota and all these 600 and more companies that were just discussed. And I think it would be useful if we took a moment to look at the historical precedents in this regard. And I'd just like to remind people, you may have heard of the Index Laboratorium Prohibitorium, which is the list of prohibited books that were prohibited by the church, the Catholic Church in this case, promulgated the index, marked, as historians say, a turning point in the freedom of inquiry in the Catholic world. The Renaissance started in Italy. It spread throughout Europe. But when Galileo Galilei wrote about Copernicus's theory that the Ptolemaic system was not correct, that the Earth was not the center of the universe, but that, in fact, the Earth and the other planets revolved around the sun, the church placed an index on Johannes Kepler's theory, which lasted until 1835. In 1966, Pope John Paul VI, Pope Paul VI, removed the index and changed the Holy Office of the Index into the Holy Office for the Propagation of the Faith. And finally, by 2007, the church decided to abolish the index because they said, and I quote from the Holy See, "The loss of relevance of the index in the 20th and 21st centuries." The significance of this for Minnesota is that this amendment has the possibility of greatly restricting scientific inquiry, and Minnesota has been a key in research and biotechnology. This threatens our position, and the threat is coming from a theological base, in my opinion, and is contradictory to the Constitution of the United States and the issue of the separation of church and state. And this has great economic consequences for the state. And for those of you who believe in scientific inquiry and progress of scientific research and progress for the economy of the state, you ought not to support this amendment. This amendment is a theological construct which has nothing to do with scientific inquiry in the 21st century. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.